Hi, Aryan here at gamedevBox. Today I'm excited to share something really cool. A prototype launcher I built for my game. You have probably seen launchers in games, such as Dev Forest. Before you jump into the game, you will see a launcher that lets you configure important settings like resolution, graphics quality, input keys, and most importantly, graphics APIs. For my game, I wanted players to have the option to choose between DirectX 11 and DirectX 12 to support old and modern graphics. As you might know, you can change the graphics API during runtime. The simplest solution, restart the game using a command line argument, something many games already do. But then I thought, why not take it a step further and create a launcher that runs before the game starts? This way, players can tweak some settings before even entering the main menu. To make it practical and simple, I set some key requirements for myself. I didn't want a separate launcher executable. Instead, the launcher and game should be part of a single exe file. First, the launcher runs, and once the player clicks play, the game launches. This keeps everything simple and contained within one project. I wanted the launcher to handle most tasks independently, with minimal interaction with the game. Of course, some connection is unavoidable, for example, settings like graphics quality or key bindings need to be saved using player prefs, JSON, or another save system, but I aimed to keep it as self-contained as possible. The launcher should only be required in a standalone build. In the Unity editor, you should be able to test the game without running the launcher. With these goals in my mind, I managed to create a working prototype in just a couple of hours. It's simple, functional, and gets the job done. Stick around because I'm going to show you how the launcher works. Walk you through the code so you can customize it for your own projects, and share tips and tricks for making your launcher even better. Oh, and the best part, you can grab the code directly from my GitHub. Where is the launcher? It's actually just a scene. I created a scene called Launcher and added to the scenes in buildlist in Unity. The important part is ensuring that this launcher scene is the first one in the list, so it always runs before anything else. A quick look at the launcher scene, there's not much going on. This scene has a camera, we don't really use it. I'm not sure if deleting it would make a difference, but I keep it for now just to be safe. The UI is the main focus here. To make it work well across the screen size, I adjusted the canvas scaler settings. Set the UI scale mode to scale with screen size, and set the reference resolution to 640 by 480. We want the launcher's resolution to be constant here. Launchers always use a fixed small window size. I also created a custom game view resolution in Unity so I could preview everything. Keep in mind, this is just a prototype. You can design it however you want, even using Unity's UI toolkit if you prefer. Here's what I included in my version. The background is an image component with a vertical layout group for positioning its two child images. A banner image. This is an image I got from Unsplash with some text added in the middle. Details panel. This panel contains drop-downs and buttons for the launcher's functionality. Inside this panel, there are quit button to exit the launcher, play button to start the game, and graphics panel, a section with its own vertical layout group, organizing three key drop-downs and a toggle. A screen resolution drop-down includes multiple resolution options. The first option labeled monitor res. dynamically sets the resolution to the current monitor resolution using Cull. This ensures the game always adjusts to the player's display, preventing any gameplay issues from mismatched resolutions. Window toggle lets the player choose between full screen and windowed modes. Graphics quality dropdown allows the player to select the desired quality level. Graphics API dropdown let the player choose between DirectX 11 and 12. That's it for the UI. It's minimal but functional, providing enough features for a basic launcher. You can add more buttons, inputs, or customization to fit your game's needs. The final piece of this launcher is an empty game object called Launcher Manager, which contains one script, Launcher Manager. I wrote all the code in this single script to keep it straightforward for beginners. The code is simple enough for everyone to understand, but you can expand and make it more advanced if you want. Now that we have covered the UI, let's dive into the code and see how it all works. These are all the libraries we are using. In the field section, we catch the camera to enable and disable it when necessary. We also define the UI elements. Launcher canvas used for enabling disabling the UI, similar to the camera. A screen dropdown to track the selected screen resolution dropdown. And windowed toggle to toggle between windowed and full screen modes. TMP dropdown for the graphics API selection. Also, I forgot to say to make sure to import TextMesh Pro into your project to use these elements. Lastly, there is a string to reference the scene that will load after hitting the play button. This should point to your main menu scene. We have a utility function called loadConfig. This function sets the screen resolution to 640 by 480 with windowed mode. We don't need to call this function manually because we have added the runtime initialize on load method attribute, the type before scene load. This ensures the function runs automatically before the first scene is loaded into memory, even before the awake function. The start method handles the initialization. It calls two key functions. Initialize launcher, this disables the launcher canvas and the main camera. It checks if a player prefs key named resolution exists. If it doesn't, we call set default resolution. In this function, we retrieve the current monitor resolution, add the word monitor in parentheses to indicate it's the current resolution, and set it as the first option in the dropdown. Manually update the dropdown label to fix a known bug where the label doesn't update automatically. Finally, save these values to player prefs under the key resolution. If the resolution key does exist, we call update resolution dropdown, passing the existing value from player prefs. This function ensures the first option in the dropdown matches the current resolution again, because we can open launcher for many times. Every time should check the current resolution again. It also updates the dropdown selected value to match the saved resolution. After handling the resolution, the initialize launcher method initializes a full screen mode. It checks if a full screen mode registry key exists. If not, it creates one. It also updates the toggle button based on the stored value. Graphics API, it sets a default value, DirectX 11, if the registry doesn't exist. After that, it's better to know if the player system is compatible with DirectX 12. It checks the player system compatibility with DirectX 12. If the system doesn't support a shader model smaller than 5.1 and DirectX 12 isn't installed, the DirectX 12 option is removed from the dropdown. If it's not the first time the launcher runs, The selected graphics API is loaded from player prefs and applied to the dropdown. Finally, the start method calls handle launcher settings. This checks if the launcher registry key exists and whether its value is zero. If it is, it applies the saved settings and starts the game. If the key doesn't exist, it initializes with a default value of one, or if exist with one value, enables the launcher UI. These are the functions each button will grab, the event and call. Let's start with a simple one. Quit button simply exit the launcher using application.quit. Set full screen mode, update the full screen mode registry. 0 means windowed and 1 means full screen. The set graphic quality function, actually I didn't write any code because this one should save a player prefs and then it should run in your main menu, so it's your job to include it. Set graphics API updates the registry with the selected graphics API, DirectX 11 or DirectX 12. Set resolution, this uses a string array that matches the options in the screen dropdown, except the first option which represents the current resolution. If the first option is selected, it returns the current monitor resolution. For other options, it retrieves the corresponding value from the array. This string can be exposed in the field section, but because our launcher scene is not heavy, we didn't really care about the performance. And also the auto garbage collector will remove it later. Play game button saves the launcher registry as 0, indicating the launcher shouldn't run next time. Determines the selected graphics API and creates a command line argument for it. For example, the dash force dash D3D11 for DirectX 11. And calls launch game with graphics API, passing the argument. This function handles running the game with the selected API. If the game is running in the Unity editor, it simply plays the game and returns, as we said earlier, we don't want our launcher to work perfectly in the Unity editor. And outside the editor, it checks for the game's executable file. If it doesn't exist, it logs an error and return. Creates a process start info with the game's path and the selected graphics API as arguments. Starts a process, run the game with the selected API, and quits the current instance of the game, means the launcher. If you remember, in the start function, we had handle launcher settings, which we said if it's 0, it would call the apply settings and start game. This shows us the previous version of our game is clicked on the play button, and actually we have to immediately enter the game. We shouldn't run the launcher here. It trims the word monitor from the resolution string to ensure proper parsing, and splits the resolution into width and height values, parses them to integers, and applies them using screen.setResolution with full screen mode data. Updates the launcher registry to 1, so the launcher runs again after the game is closed. And finally loads the main menu scene. And that's it. With just about 200 lines of code, we built a simple but functional launcher. Now it's time to assign the values in Inspector. Attach the main camera and canvas here, as well as the screen resolution dropdown, window toggle, and graphics API dropdown. For the main game scene string, I haven't created a main menu for my game yet, so I'm just using my game scene, which is called TLD. However, you should start with your main menu. Attach functions to the buttons and dropdowns. Now it's time to I give you some tips. If you encounter strange bugs or issues after modifying the code, clearing the player prefs might solve the problem. Open project settings and navigate to the player section. Under resolution and presentation, do the following. Set the full screen mode to window. Set the default resolution to match your launcher. This ensures that the game doesn't launch with an incorrect screen size on the first try. Disable the resizable window option to prevent players from manually resizing the game window, and enable the allow full screen switch so players can toggle between full screen and windowed mode. Disable the force single instance option since the launcher processes will open the game while still running. If you want a single instance setup, you will need to implement custom logic. Unity's splash screen can disrupt the appearance of the launcher. If you are using Unity 6 or newer, disable the splash screen and create your own custom one if needed. This ensures a more polished user experience. Make sure to add all the graphics APIs you plan to support in graphics API settings. Unity won't build for unsupported APIs and things might break. If you plan to add or remove any APIs, remember to update both the code and UI accordingly. If you don't care about the graphics API and only want the game to run on a supported API, you can remove that section of the code. Doing so also means you don't need to restart the game to play. You can simply load the desired scene directly. This fixes several limitations, including the need for a single instance setup. In your persistent script, a game manager or scene manager that doesn't get destroyed on a scene changes, implement an on-application quit method to reset the launcher's screen size. This minimizes jittery window resizing issues when closing and reopening the game. Keep in mind, though, that on-application quit isn't guaranteed to run every time, so it won't be a perfect fix, but it helps. Let's test it. Build your game and run the exe file. Perfect, the launcher works. You can change values, quit and reopen it to see that the settings are saved. Launch the game and it starts a new instance while closing the launcher. Simple, easy and functional, we have built our own game launcher. For the next video, I will cover pre-warming shaders for different graphics APIs to optimize game performance. Don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss it. Share your thoughts in the comments and give this video a like if it helped. Thanks for watching and have a great day.